What's going on, everybody? This is just gonna be a little part that I throw in another video, more than likely. So I've been going through some pain in the ass shit for the past about week on my daily Miata. I haven't made any videos on it because I've literally just been trying to work on it and get it finished, because that's what matters to me most right now. I haven't got to work on my red car at all for the past week. I haven't even got to drive this car at all for the past week, and I'll tell you why. I don't know exactly when, a few days ago now, I had the car idling, sitting in the garage, just warming up. I went to put it in reverse, drive it out, and as soon as I was letting off the clutch and gave it a little gas, it just backfired and started misfiring extremely bad. Come to find out that cylinder 3 fucking ejected its fucking spark plug straight out of the threads, out of the head, and just popped straight out and pulled all the threads with it out of the head, which is really, really unfortunate, just because that means I couldn't drive the Miata, because I couldn't thread a new spark plug in. But I got a repair kit. I went through a whole bunch of bullshit of the first repair kit not working, second repair kit not fitting, grinding down sockets, this, that, and the other. Just like frustrated trying to get it to work, because like I need my car to run, and the last thing I need right now is to pay a whole bunch to get all new seals, a new head, and everything. Even though it's not that cheap, I just don't want to put the money towards it. Or sorry, it's not that expensive, I don't want to put the money towards it either way. But I got one repair kit I actually think might work. I got the insert threaded in and the new spark plug.
I got the valve cover off, everything off. We were trying to diagnose what originally caused, because I didn't, whatever, but so that's off, and this is the spark plug that blew out, and as you can see, it is back in there. It is threaded in there tight as possible. So this basically just shot out and like went level up with the coil pack. It brought the plug with it, of course,
and everything. I'm really hoping that that didn't cause any more harm to the engine. Realistically, it shouldn't have, because I think that spark plug was probably just never torqued down to begin with correctly, and it eventually just backed itself all the way out and then just took itself out, or something else could have caused it. I'm not exactly sure what, but I'm gonna start throwing everything back together and hope that it starts up and everything's okay and it's not knocking or anything bad. Or doesn't eject Ocedo that fucking spark plug again.
Look at the amount of fucking shit this bitch of the last dude that had this caked on here, dude. All this RTV and shit. Like, I know you gotta put a little RTV, but come on, bruh. What is that?
Okay, so we got most of the shit cleaned off all around. New gasket is in the valve cover. As you can see, I cleaned the valve cover out, make sure there was no like flakes of anything in there, any gunk. Cleaned all the channels out in there. I forgot my big tube of RTV, the unit, so I just went and picked up this tiny little one. It will be plenty for what I need it for. I just put them around the little humps by the cams, and that's really all you need. But I figured out. Oh yeah, I forgot. I want to throw the new spark plugs in. So I'm going to throw the spark plugs in before I do this, and then we'll be good to go. Okay, got the valve cover back on. Going to do all the bolts. Got my torque wrench on the ground. I'm going to tighten these down to their spec. Busted my pinky open. No big deal. Going to tighten down these spec. I think it's 5.5 foot-pounds, but I'm going to look it up real quick and find the order. I have a picture of it in my phone. So I'm going to do that. And then hopefully she runs.
All right, so as you guys can see, everything's back together. I gotta put the heat shield and everything back on, but I didn't bolt this down. So I can still lift this up and out of the way to get the heat shield back on pretty easy.
I'm gonna open the garage door, give this girl a crank. Hope she starts, hope the engine isn't hurt, anything like that. She has oil and everything else. Let's get her going.
All right, so we're in her. I'm honestly pretty nervous.
My baby! Yes! Let's go. Okay,
so this is going to be kind of weird. I'm going to explain what happened in this car a little bit. So I'm recording this way in like the future. I don't really know. Way in the future of when the video happened, I guess. The video happened a couple weeks ago, or this all happened a couple weeks ago. I've been driving on it since, and it's been absolutely fine. I'm wanting to explain this to put in the other video to make it a little bit longer and so you guys can understand more. So I went through, as I think I explained, I blew a spark plug out of this car, out of cylinder 3. It was literally just idling here. I went to put it in reverse and it just started misfiring really fucking bad. It did a big backfire and it just sat, and it just like, I'm like, or it didn't just sit, but like, it just like scared the shit out of me. I turned it off and I went to try to figure out what was wrong with it. Realized that the plug 3 wire was like popped up like an inch, and I was like, what the fuck? Pulled the plug 3 wire out, and lo and behold, the spark plug was with it. Stripped the plugs right out of the block with it. I went through a few things. I got this kit. It came with a tap that looks just like this. Well, it is. It came with this tap right here. And it came with, I don't think it came with that one, but it came with these inserts, stuff that looks like this. Oh, fuck. Whatever. Wherever that went. Back there. It came with, oh, there it is. This one right here. And I tried and tried and tried. You had to drill out the block with like a big ass drill bit. And had to re-tap threads into the block for the new insert to go in. So your old spark plug from your, my Miata could screw on the inside of this. And for the life of me, I tried and tried and tried and tried to get this tapped into there for days. And it was literally the absolute worst thing I've like ever tried to do, because it just wouldn't work. This thing would not thread in. I tried to drill the hole out bigger than I could, everything like that. And it was giving me the hardest time possible. Lucky enough for me, I'll show you real quick. This socket right here. As you guys can see, like, it's kind of dulled down, super, super skinny. Paper thin around the edges. I had to do this so I could get another tap to work. So I went to the store and bought a whole nother tap. And this one ended up being a, to get this head in the hole, this took a 19 millimeter socket, which fit perfectly. And of course I went and bought this tap, and this hole did not fit, or this one didn't fit. And the socket that it need is a 21 mil, and that doesn't fit down the fucking spark plug hole. So I took a 21 mil socket that I went and bought from AutoZone for a couple bucks, and shaved it down for about an hour to get it as thin as possible to where it would finally fit down a spark plug hole. And it threaded in perfectly, and the insert went right in after that. I was hella scared that I was gonna have to buy a new head. And I don't know if the next video that's coming out for this, but I'll give it a peep. There's a new video coming out for this. It's a little bit louder now. I don't know. I got super excited for this when I realized I didn't have to get a new head and bought something for it, which you'll see in a future video, which I already have recorded. But yeah, I'm just been explaining this, but you can get back to
the video. You guys just saw and heard and can probably still hear behind me, the daily's back up and running, and thank goodness, bro. I've been so worried that I'm going to have to buy a new head. You have no idea what I went through trying to get this tap to work. I kind of wish I showed you guys in the long run, but it's okay. I'm just happy that it's fixed and I can get back to working on my red car to make more content for videos for you guys and to get that thing done and everything like that. It's been kind of stressful for me not having a car, having to go to work, because this literally shit out like 2 days before I had to go to work. And I just did not have the time, nor resources, knowledge, anything like that to fix it. But I figured out how to, and she's officially fixed, running again. I'm gonna let her warm up, I'm gonna give her some revs and stuff, just make sure she's all good, and then we're gonna call it there. But thank you for watching. Peace out.